Hi, today we're back here on the late casting channel. We're busy with Ashwin and Aiden's golf. We're gonna remove the oil, and then we're gonna replace the oil pump.
Well, guys, Fred already gave you guys an introduction.
A very
one, though. Well, okay. just kidding, Fred, man. Don't get so sentimental. But today we're working on Ashwin and Aiden's golf. Recent problem with the car is that we serviced the car last night and we realized that like no oil is pushing up, and that's why it sounds like the lifters is making a noise. So before replacing the lifters, we're rather replacing the oil pump first, hoping it solves the entire problem why the lifters is making a noise. After the oil pump is in, I'll give you guys a quick demonstration if the sound is still there, and maybe you guys can give you like an input on what you guys think could be the problem and what could solve the problem as well. But we're just removing the sump real quick. It's very, very easy. It's just like a lot of like holes underneath the sump. You need to loosen up, and we're just gonna drop the sump because we threw in fresh oil last night. So they're busy dropping the sump real quick, and then after that we're gonna throw the fresh oil out, and we're gonna reuse that oil once again, because I mean like the oil, we didn't even drive 24 hours with the car yet with the old oil or the new oil. But the old man is laying on the ground, and here we have the car. So the lifters is making a noise, and we really hope that it is the oil pump. But Ashwin went to Goldwagen to buy this oil pump, and I'm not sure about the brand, but apparently it's a very good brand as well. So Peterbilt is this the brand? Uh-huh. Well, apparently it's a very good brand, and trust me guys, I think I only paid $850 for it, no?
$855.
So I'm sure this one will be able to last like quite some time, because this car actually has a 272 cam in with a vernier. And that could be one of the problems why the car's oil pump actually gave in. And the oil previously in this car was a little bit sludgy. So I'm thinking this car is going through everything that Lola went through, because Lola's oil pump also gave in last year before OTF. And I had to do all this myself as well. So now we're doing the Ashwin's car a year later, and we really hope that this solves his problem as well. Oh, I'll give you guys an update as soon as we get the sump off, and I'll explain to you guys briefly how to remove the oil pump. If many of you guys didn't know this, the oil pump is situated inside the sump, meaning underneath the block of your motor. We got the oil pump removed, and literally just two long balls that goes in there and there. So I didn't film it because I was busy helping in the process, but I'm going to show you guys how to refit it. There's no gasket whatsoever. There you guys can see, just pure metal to metal for some reason. I don't know all the answers to everything, but I know there's like a pin that needs to go through here into this hole right here, or this one right here. I just need to double check, and then that's what turns everything. So yeah, I really don't know much about like the features of the oil pump, but I'll briefly explain to you guys. So whenever you remove your sump specifically, you'll have to clean this entire surface right here. You don't necessarily need to use sealant, but you can always use sealant if you just want to be 110% sure that everything will be sealed. So you just need to clean the surface right here, and as well as the surface of the sump. You need to buy a new sump gasket, obviously, when you're doing the replacement of your sump, or when you're like petering with it. So after we're done cleaning the surface right here, we're just gonna install the new oil pump, and we're gonna clean the surface on the sump as well. Put the gasket on, and then we need to hand tight all these bolts we remove right here and throw in the new oil. Very, very easy. But I'll put you guys on a time lapse as soon as we start installing the new oil pump once again. Oh, sorry, buddy. Yes, sus. Lekker Fred, man. Fred is just reinstalling the new oil pump in the car. So as soon as this is installed, again. Relax, buddy, man. Relax.
Sorry.
As soon as this is installed, we can install the sump gasket and the sump. We got everything cleaned. Where's the sump? Here's the sump and the sump gasket. We cleaned the entire sump, and I got the surface nice and cleaned up. I didn't get it like 100% cleaned up, but I just used like a little bit of sanding paper to get it nice and smooth. and I cleaned up the entire, like, yeah, all stump on the inside, a little bit on the outside. Well, the thing can still go a few knocks, also I have a few knocks, or get a few knocks. And obviously we have the gasket right here, which will be sealing the sump. So, we're just waiting for Fred to finish putting on the oil pump, and as soon as he's done right there, as soon as Fred is done here, then we can actually, yeah, start up the scar again after pouring in the oil. Is it alright, buddy?
Nee.
If you're right at home? Doesn't look alright, buddy? Like I said, there's only two bolts. Two long bolts. Fred's really busy with the one. And then obviously that pin has to clip in, Fred.
What?
That pin there in front. That pin. Yeah, that pin in front there has to clip in. So it's literally only two bolts. And then after the two bolts in and that pin is lined up, then you know you are sorted. And literally, guys, when you tighten up the sump, you can't tighten it too tight. You literally just have to, you literally just need to hand tight it with like this spline Allen key thingy. I don't know what you call this though. Yeah, anyways, I'm just gonna help Fred real quick and I'll pick up the phone or the camera as soon as we are done. But like I said, very, very easy installation.
Many, many minutes later,
we finally got the sump back on. So now we're just busy here pouring in the oil. So we're just gonna reuse the old oil which we literally threw in yesterday. And hopefully, this motor will be more quiet and will be less noisy. Because damn, I mean like, this man has spent this entire paycheck on this car this far. My bro, that has to be hard, bro. Like I previously mentioned, if the tappets or the lifters still make a noise, and I would like some advice from you guys what could be the solution to this problem. You guys can maybe just comment down below and what will be the estimated cost to like fix something like this, because I really don't have much knowledge regarding these 8 valve heads.
Many, many minutes later.
But that one is a lot of... A few minutes ago we just like finished off Ashman's car, and unfortunately, like you guys can hear in the previous clip, the noise still didn't go away. But now you guys know how to change a fuel pump, which is very, very easy, very, very basic. Say Fred, it's very, very basic to install. Very, very easy. You guys don't need to go to a mechanic to get it installed. You guys can literally do it yourself, and you guys literally just saw there on the video, very, very easy. I don't know if I did something wrong, but that's how I was taught to install a oil pump, I guess. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and please keep in mind about 12,000 subscriber surprise. So please subscribe and please to like and please to share the Facebook and the Instagram and the YouTube channel, because trust me, it's gonna be totally worth it. I saw most of you guys comments regarding like what the surprise could be, and I don't wanna like excite you guys by telling, like, revealing the surprise, but yeah, it's not a surprise if I actually tell you guys what it actually is. So keep on guessing, keep on commenting down below what you guys think the surprise could be, and hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Today's video wasn't really about just like vlogging and doing my own shit. It was just about teaching you guys how to install an oil pump, which was very basic. That's why there wasn't much explaining to do. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And remember guys, stop pressing and go stance. Talking to you free.